Is there such a thing as too much content? Evidently no when it comes to Ubisoft titles in recent years. The latest cover-based shooter from Tom Clancy's belt has grown on us, and it has managed to do so with its beautiful world and addictive loot system. You spend most of your time either feeding bullets to anything that moves, or managing how and what you use to feed said bullets. Shooting and inventory management is at the core of this game, and everything else is just in your way.
That's just a fancy way of saying everything gets sterilized.
Don't be surprised if you can't find a compelling story, and even if you do, most of it is just keywords repeating over and again. Thankfully, the setting tells a better story than its lazy cutscenes. The post-pandemic Washington DC just looks too darn good. Each nook and cranny feels like it's been affected by the green poison outbreak. This concrete jungle is sprawling with enemies to shoot, interesting loot to collect, and secret passages to explore. Throughout its 60-plus hour gameplay, you're tasked with bringing peace and prosperity back to the state of Washington, D.C. and eliminating three types of factions called the Hyenas, Outcast, and True Sons. Each of them has a slight variation. For instance, the enemy that rush you when you're facing hyenas carry a blade and breathe in green poison to go in a frenzy that let them soak up more bullets. Meanwhile, the Outcasts have suicide bombers that'll blow up in your face. Life is never comfortable in Washington DC of Division 2, and it's seriously very, very impressive. The map is divided based on levels, so you really can't venture out in any direction from the start because the higher level enemies can take you out in a sneeze. Although that's not really a big deal because each section of the map is quite big and labyrinthy, and with plenty of side quests and baddies to shoot before you move on to the next section. Each section of the map also has human encampment that is begging for an upgrade. The more baddies you clear out and help civilians in the vicinity, the faster the objectives of the encampment clear up. Much of it is just donating items to projects, clearing out control points, finding shade tech cache, clearing side missions, and helping people with resources. This obviously reimburses your time and effort with decent XP and cash, and with a chance to luck upon a better gear around the corner, which is always a compelling drive to venture out and explore. Looter shooters tend to have plenty of guns and an amazing variety of loot to make sure that your character is always up for the challenge. This is where Division 2 shines the best. It has an unbelievable depth of variation in its guns and gears, elaborated by its multi-layered customization based off perks and stats. Let me break it down. There are many different types of guns. Each gun has a level. Each gun also has tiers marked by color scheme. On top of that, every gun has some special talent, and that can be fitted with mods too. But wait, there's more. Every gun has damage, RPM, and magazine size to consider, along with accuracy, stability, reload time, critical strike range, and bullet drop-off. Whew! It's a haven for looter-shooter monkeys. And that's just guns. You have backpack, mask, body armor, gloves, holster, knee pads to consider and mix and match. Some of them have mod upgrades as well. If you think that's too much inventory management for a game, wait till you consider gadgets that can be assigned to your beck and call. Taking full advantage of the concrete jungle, the game mostly pushes you into buildings and interesting places like the Linking Memorial that fully take advantage of its cover shooter style. Vaulting over and covering behind many everyday objects was interesting too, because of how detailed each level looked. This also made offices, labs, hotels, washrooms, and just about any place in the game a really intriguing place to be in. The cover shooting is just perfect. It's simple to move from cover to cover. You need to feel me some real off. Once you leave the mission area and venture out into the open, Division 2 doesn't lose its visual fidelity. Gushing downpour and vicious thundering refreshes your mind with a different mood. Visibility takes a hit once it starts to rain, or at times when the city is blanketed in a thick fog. Stellar lightning cutting through trees and building gaps elevate the mood, which gives you a sense of time in the game world too. Sadly, the character models in the cutscenes kill the vibe of this truly gorgeous world. The elbow area and the facial expressions of some characters, namely Odessa, in the cutscene reminded us of Woody from Toy Story, minus the grill. These shortcomings are more noticeable when you play the game on 4K, and we got around 60 FPS at max settings on our RTX 2080 Ti gaming test bench. If you're stuck to a full HD screen, then it dishes out 120 frames on the highest setting. So throw in that high refresh rate monitor for some buttery smooth sniping. Much of the rave about the details and customization can quickly lose their appeal if you invest a chunk of your time gaming solo due to its repetitive nature. There are 3 dark zones now to explore that are filled with rare items. It's a fun twist to get your hands dirty by stealing and protecting your loot from others at the drop-off zone. Although that fun can quickly be replaced with irritation because of unfair difficulty. I once had a squad of 4 destroy me even before I could react. Other multiplayer modes include a quick 4v4 game, and obviously you can play the whole game with friends. Ubisoft is adding 8-player squad for the first time in the upcoming free DLC content as well. If you and a group of friends are looking for some fun shooting adventure together, Division 2 is worth every buck. It's a cowboy shooter with more than enough guns and content to spend 60 plus hours into. And judging from Ubisoft's roadmap for Division 2, they promised free and episodic content from time to time, just like Assassin's Creed Odyssey. However, if you're looking for a story-driven content and don't think nitpicking at every gear and stat is something that excites you, Division 2 will not top your list. Although we did enjoy every bit of Division 2 while playing solo as well. Guns go off with a nice crack and bang, meanwhile the enemies are relentless. Though we wish the enemy bosses had some flavor, they're just regular enemies with a lot of armor. That beautiful world and those mind-bending customizing layers in its inventory have us hooked, and it'll be the same for you too. Division 2 is a great game for people looking for a looter shooter specifically.